Well, I was diagnosed with type 1 diabetes at the age of 14 as a really active adolescent, really engaged in sports. And at the time, there wasn't really much published in the literature about how exercise and sport affect your blood sugar levels with diabetes. So after getting my PhD in metabolism, I thought it'd be great to build a camp for kids. I knew there was one for adults with diabetes who were athletes, but there's really nothing available for kids who are trying to improve in their sport. So I thought it'd be kind of interesting to start a camp about 3 years ago was the first session.
What is the purpose of this camp?
Well, this camp has a few different goals. The first goal is to offer a coaching environment for kids with diabetes where they can learn about their sport of interest, so that they can be a better basketball player, they can be a better tennis player, but also be under the right kind of clinical care so that their blood glucose levels are maintained in a safe and normal range. And we're also doing research at the camp. We're trying to learn more about how exercise and sport affects blood sugar control in kids with diabetes and how to prevent some of the lows and highs that kids can develop if they're exercising with their diabetes.
Could you please describe the knowledge mobilization aspect of the camp?
For me, knowledge mobilization is really a two-way street. We learn a lot from these kids. We learn the types of activities that can make their blood glucose drop, and the other types of activities that can make their levels go up, usually associated with adrenaline and the emotional competition. So we're learning about that using a continuous glucose monitor that we've employed during the camp that measures their blood glucose in real time and shows us graphs of where their blood sugars are. We're learning a lot about some strategies to help prevent those changes in blood sugar. And they're, of course, learning a lot from us, because all of our counselors have diabetes that are working at the camp. Many are very experienced athletes, competitive athletes with diabetes, and we've written a number of articles very recently on how to best control blood glucose levels for sport and for performance. In fact, this week we published a study from last year's camp where we showed that the blood glucose level had to really be in a normal range between 5 and 7 to optimize sport performance, and if it dropped below that, you would have a large decrement in performance capacity. And also, if it was too high, it also dropped a little bit. It's a fun camp. They're getting very elite level, university level coaching from our varsity athletes and our varsity coaches. And they're also getting the opportunity to meet other kids with diabetes who have similar interests in sport. So they're finding another child with diabetes who really loves to play tennis. And they can therefore share their experiences about competing and playing tennis with diabetes. And we also bring in guest speakers to talk about some of the things that they've accomplished with their diabetes. And then learn a little bit about their own blood glucose control.